there's really risk in everything we do and everything we don't do. And when people talk about, you know, diets, for instance, and, you know, many of us in the kind of low carb keto community have heard these diets being criticized as they're going to increase your risk of whatever it is, let's say heart disease, and that they're risky diets to take on. And you have to understand that, you know, whether or not you choose to change your diet, you're taking on some sort of risk, because if you're going to stick with whatever you are currently doing rather than changing, there is risk associated with that. And we know that the standard American diet, the kind of default diet that most people are on in the United States, and quite frankly, worldwide these days, carries significant risk with it. When we look at the risk of heart disease, it is currently very high. Heart disease is the number one killer in the United States and worldwide, and that it has been the number one killer for many years, going back 20, 30 years at least, the risk of heart disease has remained high. And that is, you know, with people following the standard American diet. We also know that currently 88% of the adults in the United States are not metabolically healthy. They cannot meet all five criteria of good metabolic health. And there is a lot of risk associated with that. So one of the things that I get people, I hope people understand, and that I try to get people to realize as I'm working with them, you know, one-on-one or, you know, in the messaging I put out there, is that there is a lot of risk of just continuing to do what you're doing if all you're doing is the standard advice and maintaining a standard American diet. Association does not mean causation. And this becomes very relevant when we talk about, you know, diet, because most of the studies, most of the scientific studies that are done on diet are what are called epidemiologic studies. And they basically look at what people are eating and they correlate these to their health outcomes. But it's important to understand that epidemiologic studies, by the way that they are done, by their nature, cannot prove that, you know, one thing leads to another. In our case, it cannot prove that eating a certain diet leads to a certain outcome. It can only associate those two. And association does not mean causation, because there can be other factors, you know, besides the diet that are causing some of the outcomes. And it just so happens that people who, let's say, eat a certain way also tend to have other certain habits. For instance, you know, people who eat a vegan diet are less likely to smoke. So when we see that, you know, there might be some positive outcomes associated with a vegan diet, you know, through epidemiologic studies, there's no way to say it's the vegan diet that's in particular causing those outcomes. It may be the other things that those people do in their life. So very important to remember that.